Hi, and welcome back to MyExcelOnline.com. Today we are going to go over how to insert a histogram in Microsoft Excel.
If you want to learn more about Microsoft Excel and Office, join our Academy online course and access more than 1,000 video training tutorials so that you can advance your level and get the promotions, pay raises, or new jobs. The link to join our Academy online course is in the description.
So here I am in Excel, and I have some data over here in a table where I have guest names and age. So if I were to highlight all of my data and go over here to insert and select this option over here, I can insert a histogram. And I get the most basic generic histogram, but it is telling me the information that I want to see. So if I want to change the chart title, I can click here, highlight it, and just call it guests. And then there's a lot of other things I can do to my histogram.
If you are liking this video, please give us a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel and hit the bell button to get notified when we release our weekly videos.
So selecting the histogram itself, right now you can see I have this label selected. So if I click over here in Excel and just come back on the chart, I have the chart itself selected. And if I go up here to chart design, I have some options that I can do. I can add a chart element. So let's see what kind of options I have under here. So what I would like to do is I would actually like to come down here and go to data labels, and I would like to have a sum total at the top. So I'm going to do outside end right here. And now you can see that I have data labels up here. Also, if you look up here, you can change the style of your chart. I can put a black background in, I can have it a little more shaded, or any of these options up here that you like. I'm just going to go back to the basic one because it's the easiest one to see. If I double click here, I will have some other options for my chart that appear. And one thing I would like to do is maybe change the color of these columns here. So if I click on the paint can here and go under fill, I can see that there's a color here. And if I select this down arrow, let's say I want the color to be red. And now I have changed my graph to red. Now, what if I wanted my graph to be a little bit bigger? Well, once I have the graph selected, look at my mouse, how it changes as I move it down here. It moves from this white filled in cross to this black lined cross with arrows on it. When I have the lined arrow cross, if I hold down with my left mouse button, I can click and drag and reposition this wherever I would like it. And then if I go over any of these circles, I will get a double headed arrow. So if I go to this bottom right hand corner, I can actually click and drag and make my graph a little bit bigger. Now, what is my histogram actually telling me? Well, what it's telling me is how many people I have from age 3 to 22. I have 10. What about 22 to 41? I have 12. And 41 to 60, I have 6. And 60 to 79, I have 2. But what if I wanted to change these groupings? If I right-click on here and I go to Format Data Series, if I click this down arrow and go to Access Options, my horizontal axis, I have bins right here. And right now my bin width has been determined by Excel. So let's say I go down here to bin width. Instead of the numbers that Excel has chosen, instead of 19, let's make this 10. And if I just hit Tab to get out of there, I can see that Excel has recalculated and now I'm grouping people within 10 years for each column that I have in my histogram. So whenever you design a chart inside Microsoft Excel, you have a lot of options. You can change colors, fonts, you can change the titles, you can add a lot of different formatting, and you can also add some more chart elements. We get into this a little bit more in our histogram blog. I'll include a link to that below in the description if you would like to check that out more. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them below and we'll get back to you. Thanks for watching and see you again next time.
If you want to learn more about Microsoft Excel and Office, join our Academy online course and access more than 1,000 video training tutorials so that you can advance your level and get the promotions, pay raises, or new jobs. The link to join our Academy online course is in the description.
If you like this video, subscribe to our YouTube channel. And if you're really serious about advancing your Microsoft Excel skills so you can stand out from the crowd and get the jobs, promotions and pay rises that you deserve, then click up here and join our Academy online course today.